Hello. How you doing? Yeah. Cool. Oh, I've just been learning how to make rocket stoves. Yeah, everything's going very well. Everything's going just as I figured. So. Oh, yeah? That's good. And I'm over here at the library. Looks like YouTube has to have an upgraded browser to do any videos. So, yeah. So, we've got the cold season now, so. Set up a rocket stove outside so I could boil water. Or heat up food. Heat my feet up too. I recorded it on my little Mac device or iPhone thing, but trying to get it transferred is the turn into a tool. Some reason. I think it's because the browser has to be updated. But in order to do that, I gotta get Tiger or 10.5 because I only have 10.4. So I think so. We'll see. I'll keep fiddling around and see what I can do. Hey, you know what's on the back of a brown recluse spider? A fiddle. Now, a brown recluse spider won't bug anybody, but if you bug it and it gets to the point where it has to defend itself, then it will bite, and its bite is very spectacular. So, when you say you're just going to be fiddling around, it has more than one meaning to it, didn't you? If you've read the whole dictionary. It takes a long time to read the whole dictionary, man. It's like reading a good book. I've just been reading all kinds of different books. Learned about philosophy, the Philosopher's Stone. So, since Freemasonry is big now on YouTube, all the secrets are coming out. So, they deem that the public is ready. So. Everybody's going to have an equal opportunity now. All those at the bottom of the pyramid, so. Solutions and Commerce, It's all public on YouTube videos. Yeah. One of the best. What seems to be the best teachers to listen to is Winston Shrout, so at least because that's what it took for me. So, yeah. Basically, you learn how to write up a security agreement and a lien, and record it in the public, and then. But I learned how to write my affidavits from Long. Long and Greasy. That's where I learned all about affidavits. Basically, he said, you can write anything you want in crayon and have it witnessed, and it stands. But then Winston taught that your affidavits that you write are the court, if you understand what you're doing. So I put two and two together and learned that I can write anything I want on my affidavits and get the other party's agreement through non-response. So, whenever you write to the corporation and send them a witnessed affidavit, they will not respond. Otherwise, they would be putting on the record, they would be committing treason is what it comes down to. And they won't do that. They know better, so. There's an open door for those who learn the process and the knowledge of the ancients, the Freemasons, the Philosopher's Stone, the security agreement, and the commercial lien all ties in together. Natural law. It's all connected. It all has something in common, and that's cause and effect. It's the cosmos is the father, and Mother Nature is the mother. There's a union between the two, and that's the philosopher's stone of neutrality, being able to find balance in life, both physically and spiritually, most importantly. Balance between the two, between the spirit and the body, so that we can actually walk eternally on this life right now. Now, other men have already achieved it, but the universe decided it was not time for them to remain. But the time is ready for those to start remaining. So, that's my goal, is to enter into that. And from what I'm picking up from the universe, I am going to be the first one that's going to set that pace. So, but we aren't going to know it until after we examine my life and see that I've been hanging around here on the earth for a while. Then people examine the birth certificate through the public record. They see that I've been around for past 140 years, up to 150 years, going on 160, all the way up to 200, 210. That's national emergency right there in common. So that'll be a real good giveaway. But that's the evolution of the future of mankind, is to remain in these bodies on this earth, but it takes balance between the spirit and the body, and that's a uniting of the Western thought and the Eastern thought. So, the dude named Jesus, was able to do that, but his time was not to remain on this earth. Mankind was not ready. So he had to go. But the hardest part is finding the balance. Because in life, our throttle gets either stuck closed or stuck wide open. Each day is kind of different. So, it takes education, both in the books and then practical application through experience in life, where you actually get in the backyard and you start being quiet with yourself, meditating, getting to know your thoughts. And recently, the state that I live in has just passed the cannabis to allow for people to be able to use it for those under the legal codes. Then that'll be an open door for them to be able to use that as meditation medicine, so that they can actually sit down and be quiet with themselves and figure out how their thoughts work and connect with their spirit. So it's a tool. So it's no big secret. Recently, Oregon, Alaska, and Washington, D.C., the big three. Government decide to allow it to happen. Nothing happens without the government's say. So if you think the people did it, they didn't. Actually, it was the universe who allowed it to happen. And it was time. That shift was time. But the dead giveaway is that Alaska, Oregon, and Washington, D.C. are the three cornerstones of the United States. If you draw your line, they're all three in alignment. Go straight from Alaska through Oregon to Washington, D.C. So the stars have lined up. Big giveaway too is that Washington, D.C. decided at the same time. No other states were included. So there's the big giveaway if you're able to see it with your eyes. So. Yeah, everybody's at the bottom of the pyramid will have equal opportunity to see that in order to move up in life, you have to educate yourself. But the only way I educated myself is I was forced into it. So, some people it takes being forced into it. Your circumstances will force you into it. So, for instance, the circumstances that I had was bills. And when I found out the information, maritime and private maritime law, you find out that all you gotta do is send an affidavit to the corporations, to all the banks, and ask them to verify their debts. And they won't do that because if they did, they'd be committing treason. Because they know that all paper money is backed by the people. Ever since 1933, public law went into effect, H.J.R. 192. Due to the national emergency, all past and future debts are now canceled. So, in order to refinance for the bankruptcy, they had to use collateral. And that collateral was the people. So the people are the backing of the dollar. paper money. All credit. But in order to access, you have to learn about private maritime law. The best place I recommend to learn from is solutionsofcommerce.com. There are all kinds of other men to learn from, but the only one that I found so far that has a consistent flow of information to build a foundation upon, from one man, to hear from the voice of one man, and to listen to his experiences too, is Winston Shrout. He was, from last I saw, based out of the Hillsboro, Oregon. So, everybody will be on the same footing. Especially when, you know, other men come on the scene and explain to public relations in a way that the public can kind of understand it without rioting. Because that's the main thing that the people, that the national leaders, international leaders have been waiting for, is someone who's able to explain stuff to the people. Public won't get mad and start to riot, and I'm one of those people. So, but it's all just a matter of time. So, that's my gift. Being able to explain the bankruptcy of the United States in tandem as to why cities were built to bring people out of the jungle. For the evolution of mankind, to bring protection. Because out in the jungle, it's kill or be killed. That's why cities were built. But eventually, there has to be an equality set up where all people have the opportunity to be able to walk side by side in the knowledge. So, if you're at for people at the bottom of the pyramid, all they gotta do. They can start off free if they want on YouTube and listen to all the free videos that are already there. Winston Shrout, a lot of his seminars and DVDs are on YouTube, and it will give someone a start to at least be able to see. Oh. Well, yeah, there is something else to life than what I've been involved in. And hopefully, eventually, they will get a hold of the actual seminars from front to back and watch them from front to back. Get about 10 of them, man. And don't forget to get the commercial lien DVD. And the one with Paul Zuccardi. The A for V. So, that gives you a little information. But, But if someone at the bottom of the pyramid can at least see that the information is there and available, then he can start to begin his own self-education. It's private education, because until such time as this gets brought into the public. Public universities is where it's going to be. But right now, it's all private. People at the bottom of the pyramid can learn the information, and they can get themselves out of the matrix, stand as a private man in the public. And learn, and basically what they're going to be doing when they start to understand the paperwork that they put in is that they just created an international peace treaty that stands at the world court. Come to an understanding that if they break their peace treaty, then the corporation can come down on them. Because people at the top like to make sure that peace is maintained, because that's the main thing on earth, is maintain the peace and harmony. Not to bring any harm to anyone, so. But if you accidentally do any harm and for the sake of commerce, then you are covered through the unlimited insurance bond known as the corporate birth certificate. And everyone is considered a shareholder in that corporate stock, that corporate birth certificate application bond. It is the insurance that all public insurance policies are written from. So, you'll learn how to access that bond and write your own private promissory notes. If you have an accident and something needs to be paid for, and you'll learn how to enforce those bonds or those promissory notes if they've been rejected, or in other words, dishonored. Basically, you have the chain of command. You have your city police chief, your county sheriff, your federal marshal, your military commander, your international military commander. And you also have, under the federal, you have the IRS, who does enforcement. They have the Criminal Investigation Department. And you also have the Universal Postal Union. So there's many different routes. And you, so you go up the chain as you need. If you need enforcement. That's if you need enforcement. If you know how to enforce everything yourself, and all is fine and dandy there too. But the key to enforcing everything yourself is being at peace. Doing everything honorably, peacefully, calmly and gently, and softly. Well, like I said, I've taken myself off the grid. And if you do that, you're going to get a So knock on the door from the city inspectors. So all you got to do is tell them the situation, and they understand. Just let them know you went off the grid. If that's what you want to do as your option. I'm not saying everybody has to go off the grid. You can remain on the grid or not. It's all up to you. I, for one, in my heart, see, I had to follow my own heart. You have to follow your heart. In my heart told me I need to go off the grid, so I did. I cut the water and the power. And so now I live off rainwater. And I've learned how to build a rocket stove for fire so I can heat stuff up. Rocket stoves are smokeless, so but when you first fire them up, they are do have a little smoke. If you build them right, they're smokeless. So basically all you need to live is fire and water, the four elements of life, fire, water, earth, and air. If you know how to use those, you can live without the regular utility hookups. It's up to you. So, I'm not saying one way is better than the other. It's just your option. But that's where I'm at. So I've got fire, water, air, and shelter, and I'm good to go. So, tax-free, tax-exempt. The county sends their paperwork and they say, hey, pay your taxes. And so you just say, here's my lien. And so they back off because they know. So you have to go through all the fear, though, because there's all kinds of different routes they use. They have to test you. They will test you to see if you know how to stand on your own and if you really know your information. Like I say, I started 5 years ago with 12 banks all at one time. That's the way I learned how to do it. That's the only way I could see how to do it because that's the situation I was in. So I wrote one affidavit. I put all 12 banks on it. And I had to verify their debts. And they couldn't. So, therefore, I got their agreement that all the debts don't exist. Because they know that when they loaned us the money, they reached into our birth certificate, bond account, pulled that credit out, and gave it back to us. And it had to be done that way. So there's no reason to get mad at them. That's the evolutionary process that it took to move men from the jungle to the cities. To get mankind to a point where they can educate themselves and walk side by side in peace instead of killing each other in the jungle. So. Once you get a taste that the affidavit is the court, and you get a taste that their non-response is agreement, then you start to build your confidence up. And you start to actually see step by step, even when they send service process service to the door to knock on the door. And then they send information to the court. And the court sends information back. And then you learn how to deal with the court and process service and everything through affidavits. And you put it in the public record, and any public record is a good public record. It doesn't have to be the courthouse. Any record on the internet, any record in the public as you continue your studies. Get the DVDs from Solutions and Problems. Listen to what Winston, my sister, I teach, so that you know for yourself, and you can actually do the research yourself. Get on the internet, because all the information is on the internet, accessible to everybody. Basically, the corporation is every corporation all tied into one. It's basically one corporation. All the different names of the corporations are just there for keeping track of where everything's at. But it all falls into one corporation. There's one corporate birth certificate, application bond, one corporation. And that's all unity.
He said, children always get it right. He said, regular people always get it right. Because it's a trick.
It's unity as one.
Yeah.
But, one spirit. Yeah, one body. Although we are many people, we're one body and one spirit. But same thing with the corporations. There's one corporation, although there are many different corporations, the shadows. Different shadows, there's different shapes. When you put your hand up on the wall, see? There's different shapes. Put your hand on the wall, there's different shadows. You turn it one way, the shadow changes. Different shapes. So each man is a different shape of the same shadow. Just a different angle. And these are all things that you learn when you start sitting down in the backyard and studying nature, the sun and the moon.
How does that?
Well, I think that'll be good. So, I'll talk to you later. And, enjoy. Enjoy your Thanksgiving. And, later on, you'll learn about the red man and the native. And the Iroquois, who were never defeated in the North American plains. The Iroquois, the United States, made a peace treaty with the Iroquois Indians because they could not defeat them. So, I just happened to be an Iroquois Indian. That's why I am where I am. It's in my heart, in my blood. So, all right. So, I'll talk to you later.